What's the difference between this and this or this? Do you want to convert this or into this? Or do you just want to understand the difference and know the technology behind these incredible images? So, you are very lucky, because I'm here to introduce you to infrared vision in three easy points. 1. What is an infrared image? 2. Types of infrared cameras. And 3. What infrared cameras are useful for? Let's start with these 3 points. But first, I should say that at the end of this video, I'll let you know a big announcement or surprise that I'm very proud to bring to this channel. I still can't believe it. 1. What is an infrared image? This is the common RGB visible picture that we all know. And this is an infrared image. But also this is an infrared image. So what's the difference between them? The answer is the wavelength of the light captured in each one. But what is the wavelength? Well, it's a physical property of the light or radiation that we can see or not with our eyes. The light that we can see with our eyes is called visible light, and we can classify the light or radiation that we can't see into ultraviolet and infrared light. If we are talking about near infrared light or radiation, we can obtain these cool images. But if we are talking about middle or far infrared radiation or light, we'll get this kind of images. Once that we have learned this, let's start with our 2, types of infrared cameras. Let me ask you a question. What do you do if you would like to get visible images? Well, it's very easy. You just need to use your common smartphone camera. But what happens if we are talking about near infrared images? So we need a near infrared camera, usually known as night vision or surveillance camera. And we have 2 options. The first one, you can purchase your own device. And the second one, and most interesting, you can hack your own smartphone or web camera. Yes, common visible cameras, that is your smartphone camera, can capture near infrared light. These cameras include near infrared blocking filters to show us images as we see the world. So we just need to remove this glass filter physically, and there it is. Your camera can capture visible and near infrared light, and you'll get images like this. And if you want to see in the dark, you'll need a near-infrared spotlight. It's important to point out that some specific mobile phones already include near-infrared cameras. In this video, I show you how to access most of them using my Android apps. If you want to go to the next level with it, you can visit RGMVision.com. Middle and far infrared cameras. These devices, known as thermal cameras, can capture the middle and far infrared, getting images like this. Giving us the capability to measure temperatures. In this case, if you want one of these devices, you only have one option. You need to purchase a thermal camera. And yes, this technology is more expensive. I'm sorry. But if you desire to travel to the thermal camera world, you should check out the description of this video. There, I recommend you the best quality price thermal camera, the RGMVision ThermalCAM 1. And in this video, using this device, I show you how to turn your smartphone into a thermal camera. Boom! just in a sec. Finally, let's talk about our third point. What infrared cameras are useful for? Near infrared cameras are commonly used for 1. Surveillance applications. 2. Facial and iris biometric recognition. 3. Animal research surveillance. And 4. Hunting. On the other hand, thermal or middle far infrared cameras allow us to 1. Detect wildfires. 2. Supervise electric panels, heating systems, or electronic devices. 3. Measure the temperature in COVID access controls. And 4. Unfortunately, in my opinion, use them in military missions. And now, before my promised big announcement, I would like to encourage you to engage with me and this video. I'll give you 3 simple ideas, but only if you have learned something or you have reinforced previous knowledge. You can give me thumbs up. You can subscribe to this awesome channel and join the RGMVision community. Or you can share this video if you think that somebody could be interested in it. Thank you so much. And now, as I promised, here it goes, my announcement. If you are a computer vision lover or you want to apply what we have learned during this video, I'm very proud to let you know that thanks to Adrian Resbrook from PyImageSearch.com, this is part of the introduction of the Infrared Vision Basics course. There, you will learn how to combine computer vision, deep learning, and infrared vision. You have, with all my love, the link to this free course in the description of this video. And that's all. I hope you have enjoyed this video and see you in the next classes where we have learned how to master or use computer vision to measure temperatures. See you in the next videos. Bye.